In this video, I'm going to show you how to use store processor with parameter. That's, we are passing some parameter, and based on the parameter value, we can filter the output. Previous video, we just seen the how to use store processor, but in this video, I'm going to show you how to pass parameter to store processor, your store processor. Okay. Here, this is our store processor. Here I created one parameter, that is, I am passing the ID for the table. Based on the ID, it will give the result. Let's we execute this in SQL Server. I have to pass the ID, so I'm passing ID. See, for ID 5, it gives name. Okay, so same thing we have to achieve through APOT. First thing, we have to create a variable ID. Okay, that is integer variable. Okay, good. Then we have to pass the ID, right? So we have to assign it ID, some ID, whatever ID you like. Then go to edit query. This is continuous of a previous video, so you have to see the previous video. Parameters, here we have to create a parameter. This is at ID, because type is integer, then we have to assign that variable ID, which is already created. Okay, that's all. Now we have to display the result, right? So I'm going to display the name. So for each row in this table, whatever user table, okay, get row item. From this row, I'm going to display the name. So first name, exactly first name. Copy this column name. Okay, that's all. Value. Okay, that's all. Then we have to display this. Okay, now let's we execute this one. Okay, let's we execute this. I passed ID 7, so it will display result for 7. Okay, the same thing. Now I am going to pass some other ID, 2. Okay, okay, good. We are getting the expected result. Here you have to notice one thing, the input parameter, the parameter at ID should be same whatever created the parameter. It is case sensitive. If you change something, then it won't work. So here, whatever parameters, if you have one more parameter, then you have to give the same parameter whatever created here. Okay, thank you.